morning, church.
Good morning.
What a joy on this blessed Mother's Day when many around the world gather in worship to celebrate mothers. I am happy to extend Happy Mother's Day to all mothers and those who stand in the gap for mothers. And now, we begin the worship service with the intro, the Women Fellowship Choir. Guidance in our lives. Respect all women in our midst, mothers and aunts, and sisters and friends together.
We thank the Lord for the many women who influence our lives in so many ways. We pray that we will honor them in everything we do. Amen.
hour of prayer, sweet hour of prayer, that calls us from a world of care and lays us at our Father's throne, make all our wants and wishes known. Heavenly Father, we give you thanks for mothers everywhere. We give thanks for their love, care, concern, and compassion. We lift up to you especially those who have struggled in their role as mothers, where the path has not been smooth. We pray for those whose mothers perhaps failed in any way. Bring hope in the midst of their lives, whether as mothers or as children. For those relationships that are strained, grant reconciliation where there's pain. Bring the healing of your grace and mercy. May our own hearts of love extend to all mothers everywhere, especially, Lord, for those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for those who are lost and alone, for those who yearn to be given new direction, new hope, and new life. We pray in the name of Jesus that you would care for them through us. Thank you, Father, for your strength in times of need, for comfort in times of distress, encouragement in times of despair, guidance in times of uncertainty. Lord, we thank you for this day and all its blessings, and we offer you all the praise, all the glory, and the honor in Jesus' name. Amen. The act of penitence and assurance of forgiveness. Let us in a moment of silence. Let us pray a prayer of penitence together. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against each other in thoughts, in words, and in deeds. In the evil we have done, and the good we have failed to do, some through ignorance, some through weakness, some through our own deliberate fault. We have been unwilling to accept the great works you have done in our lives and the lives of others. Our faith has been weak, our gratefulness has been lacking, and our hearts have been hardened. We are truly sorry, Lord, and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life to the glory of your name. Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Assurance of forgiveness. Remember that Christ Jesus died for all of our sins, and if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us. Therefore, my brethren, be assured that our sins are forgiven.
Amen. Thanks be to God.
Let us pray the collect together. God, our Redeemer, you have delivered us from the power of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of your Son. Grant that by his death he has called us to life, so by his continued presence in us, he may raise us to eternal joy. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen.
A woman. President Sister Carla Bartlett will now give welcome remarks. Good morning. Good morning again.
Good morning.
And we welcome all of you, especially those who are watching via Facebook. We are so delighted that you have come to worship with us on this very special day. Today, we honor mothers and Mother Benedict.
mothers. You are so awesome. So awesome. God has blessed you with some fine work. This morning I want to say to you that you have one of the toughest jobs in the world, but also one of the most rewarding. The intolerable pain from the children's birth to the welfare of their very own, sleepless nights and struggles so immense, yet an invincible strength and resistance. She is the one who carries us in our hearts and in our hands, unflinching and unrelenting. In her we see the definition of grace. She is the one who comforts and keeps us safe, the one who prays and the one who stays, and gives us the unconditional love of a thousand sacrifices. Despite all the challenges she faces, she shapes the lives of her children and creates a lasting impact in the world. She is the beauty her words cannot explain. To every mother and mother figure, this morning we say a blessed and a happy Mother's Day. If your mother is here this morning with you, I need you to turn to her right now. Hug her. Kiss her. Squeeze her. And let her know how much you appreciate her. And if you listen to my prayer, I'll be going to where she is. The love of a mother is something no one can understand. Mothers, we love you because God has blessed us with you. This morning I say again, welcome.
Are your thoughts, O God? cover and the song of them.
I cry upon them, they have fallen aside. I come to the end, I will sail with you.
Glory of God.
By her daughter, Sister Erica Weir, and the next voice you will hear will be our speaker.
Good morning and happy Mother's Day to each and every one of our mothers. It's a joy to see so many beautiful faces in the congregation. Welcome. It is indeed my pleasure and a privilege to introduce our guest speaker. She's absolutely no stranger to us. She's Mrs. Ena Johnson Weir.
I have to say to my sister, I found out your maiden name, Johnson. I never knew that.
Okay. Born in the parish of Hanover, Jamaica, to the parents of the late Herbert Alexander Johnson and Iris Moore Johnson. She's the last child of a family of 12. Her father was married twice. When her father's first wife passed, he married Ena's mother. The two unions produced 4 boys and 2 girls, each ending in a family of 8 boys and 4 girls. She attended Mannings High School in the parish of West-More Land. Mrs. Weir lived with her brother and his wife at Wesley Mt, Manchester, where her brother was principal. From there, she went to St. Joseph Teachers College, taught at Allman Town Primary School for 1 year, then went to St. Benedict University and St. John's University. Soon after that, she met and married the love of her life, the late Reverend Dr. James J. Emmette Weir, on July the 8th, 1972. They were then sent to Governor's Harbor, Eleuthera, before relocating for many years to Nassau, where she taught at Treasury School for 1 year, then went to Queens College, where she taught for 37 long years. In 2001, they moved to Freeport, Grand Bahama, where she taught at St. Paul's College and Bishop Michael Elvin School for 4 years. Her husband, the late Reverend Dr. J. Emmette Weir, was pastor of St. Paul's Methodist Church and President Emeritus. He has since gone on to be with the Lord on April the 30th, 2021, leaving behind his son Ellsworth, who was married to Camille, his daughter Erica, and his grandsons, Jaden and Jordan. I know this lady is like my big sister. Sometimes she can even be my mother, and she's definitely a friend. And it's such a joy to welcome her. And I now invite her beautiful daughter, Erica, who would grace us with her and for the
Mother's Day to all the beautiful mothers in the house, and of course to my lovely mother. Before I say, I just want to say on this special day, I want to say a special thank you to Moni, the most perfect mother and grandmother that God could have blessed my brother and I with. You are a true example of godliness and faithfulness. You have done so much for Elsworth and I over the years, and we are forever grateful. You loved deeply and wanted nothing but the best for us. And your warm yet tough love was fueled by the desire to see us succeed in life. Ellsworth, now the director of parks across the country, and me, a music teacher for many years. If it hadn't been for you paying for those private piano lessons, I would not have been where I am today. We feel the prayers you pray for us every day. So thank you, thank you, thank you, Mommy. You've had your good days and not so great days over the years, but I've seen you overcome with grace and strength. And through it all, God has truly been good to you. And I know Daddy, whose birthday is also today, is proud of you and looking down, smiling. So keep trusting and believing. We love you.
Genesis 2, 18 to 24. Then the Lord God said, it is not good. I will make him a helper as his partner. So out of the ground, the Lord God formed every animal of the field and every bird of the air and brought them to the man to see what he called them. And whatever the man called to every living creature, that was its name. The man gave names to all cattle and to the birds of the air and to every animal of the field. But for the man, there was not found a helper as his partner. So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man, and he slept. Then he took one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. And the rib that the Lord God had taken from the man, he made into a woman and brought her to the man. Then the man said, this at last is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman, for out of man this one is taken. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Today is his birthday. Okay, today I'm going to talk to the, it's just so much the Lord wants me to say. I was told that I was born from a big family, yes. I was the last of 12 children, so I was spoiled. I had the opportunity of moving from one to the next. When I'm tired of one, I go to the next. But God, I grew up in a Christian home, Methodist. My father was like the pastor for the church, because the churches in Jamaica are far apart. So he was like the pastor, but he was such a Christian man. My mother didn't have to do very much, because my brothers and sisters knew what they were supposed to do, and he made it, and that makes it much easier for the family. But we were blessed by God. Out of the 8 boys, 4 were local preachers. And I never heard my father ever have to speak to those boys about doing stuff or going here or doing whatever. On a Sunday, church, everybody would never question it. You know, Sunday is a holy day and it's God's day. So we got ready we took our clothes off from Saturday night. And we are ready for church on Sunday. And my sister from the last wife, she was the organist for the church. My father preached, he was the Sunday school superintendent. He was able to bury the dead. The only thing he couldn't do was marry. He was not a married man. And people respected us. And you think about it, they respected us because we were Christians. Mothers, you know, it's not only mothers, fathers as well. You have to take up your stand in the homes. It makes it so much easier for mommy. Much easier. My mother didn't have to talk to her children because they just know what to do. They did the right things. But you know, I told some nurses came to see me the other day, and I told them, I said, you need to let your children or grandchildren you have a culture for them, a job for them to do in the mornings before they go to school, and in the evening, get them busy. And you won't have trouble of trying to find them here and there and why they didn't come home and the rest of it. It's a different day we are living in. Now, I have chosen three ladies from the Bible, and I won't dwell on them that long because I want you to hear my life story. I chose Dorcas because Dorcas made all these beautiful things, clothes and garments, and I compare myself to Dorcas because I like to use my hands. Come to my house, you will see all sorts of things because that's what I like to do. And I do gardening. So it keeps me busy. Now, I know Dorcas at her death, you know, they were showing the garments that she made. So I know she was a busy woman. And then I chose the woman at the well. She doesn't have a name, but she went, as you know the story, went to the well to draw water, and Jesus was there. He probably didn't know it was Jesus, and Jesus asked her a drink of water, and she refused, and Jesus said, if you know who asked for this water, you will give. And when she found, Jesus told her a life story, and she went back to the village and said, come see a man that can tell you all these things about yourself. And I looked upon her as a missionary, because when you bring people to Jesus, you're really telling a story about Jesus. So I looked upon her as a missionary. And then we had Mary Magdalene, who went to the site where Jesus was buried. So Mary also went back and told the others, and they came to see. I don't want to dwell on the ladies of the Bible is very relevant at this time. We know that. It never goes out. But this day and those days are completely different. And so we have to go to God and find out how to deal with our children. My daughter is teaching now, it's different from when I was teaching. She tells me the things that happen in school. You would never believe the little children that they could do such things. So something is going on, and we as mothers have to be aware of what's happening. You know that in Nassau it's terrible. Something is wrong. What are we going to do? What are we going to do? We have to pray and pray and pray for these children. Now, when I was in Scotland with my husband, and I had developed a fear in Nassau. And I went to Scotland, and when it was time to come home, I came before my husband. He had a semester leave, and I came home because I had to go back to work in September. And so I was so full of fear that I did not know what to do. And I cried out to the Lord. I said, God, you have to do something for me. I cannot go back to the Bahamas like this. I need this fear to get away from me. The children were small. They were with us in Scotland. And God is awesome, people. When I tell you, we serve an awesome God. I prove it in my daily life. The next day after I cried out to God, I went in town and I met this, and this girl came up to me. And she said, she asked my name and where I was from. And she asked me if I was a Christian. Well, I was a Christian, but I know my weaknesses and I just had this fear. She came to pray for me the next day, but she said, you know, I could not penetrate that wall. The next day, and I'll never forget because that's the day when Prince Charles was married to Lady Di. And she came to pray for me. And I saw myself, people, as a cocoon under the cross of Jesus. And that blood dripped on that cocoon and it broke and opened up and I became a beautiful butterfly. And listen, God started moving in my life. I never was the same anymore. I went to Nassau, I went back, and somebody had somebody for me to pray with. Well, he's a pastor. He came to see me, and I was telling him, and he sent somebody to pray with me. But you know what? I couldn't pray for one whole year. She came, but I just cried, I cried, I cried, I cried for a whole year. I was on a QC teaching. I went out to do PE with the children. And I said, Lord, why are the people's hearts so hard? And God said, as it was in the days of Noah, so shall it be. And he removed that burden from me immediately. And all things, I was going to say something else, but I changed my mind. All things broke loose. Hallelujah. I started as a, I did everything that, oh God, he used me in such a mighty way. He used me in such a mighty way. I got filled with the Holy Spirit and I discovered other people in the church are getting filled. So we said, okay, there are some people in the church. We said, we can't leave the church. We got to do something. So we formed a prayer group. And we had 630 people on a Saturday evening, every evening, rain or shine, they were there. And it was powerful, powerful. They would be calling up each other and said, what happened the last half an hour? What happened in the last hour? Things was just moving like that in our lives. And I, at QC, I worked, I did a lot. I did a lot. God used me at QC. I remember one Halloween, a teacher then was planning to have this Halloween party to the point where they would block off the room. I suppose it's ketchup. They had in a pot to cook to show the children. That's fierce. I got crazy. Well, I just got crazy. And I said, this is not happening on this campus in the name of Jesus. And I, that morning of Halloween, oh God, I opened the gate. My husband was living next to this school because he was whatever at this time.
And so the gate just opened between QC and us. And I went, and I stepped. If the ground could move, it would move. And I walked down to that classroom, and I stamped into my classroom, and I said, God, do something. And I hear a big explosion immediately. Not a second after I said, God, do something, because he expected me to do my part, and now I expect him to do his part. And that explosion was the transformer, blew up immediately, and they could not do anything for that day. They came running into my classroom. Were you praying? I said, yes, and then I was praying. I said, but you got to pray for yourself. And that, you know what? The Holy Spirit says, not finished. And the next year, they came into my classroom and said, they're not doing anything. I'm telling you, people of God could use you to the core. Just for us to yield unto him. I prove it every step of the way. But God is a good God. He will not leave us comfortless. There are so many things that I know God has done for me that I cannot turn my back on him. God is a good God. He just wants us to yield. Mothers, please, please, please look after the children. Make sure what you speak before them is unto God. Make sure that you pray with them. Make sure that you know what they're doing at school, because these are serious times. These are serious times. It's not like years and years long ago, but this is a time of, I say, the devil let loose, because the things that are happening, now, a few years ago, they weren't happening. These things weren't happening. It's a different time. I can imagine children going on campus with guns and knives. And where did we get these things from? We, as parents, have to supervise our children, know what they're doing, and because there is nothing that God can change. You pray over your children. Even if you have to anoint them, you anoint them. Because God is depending on us as mothers. Fathers, please take your rightful place. Because it's hard on mothers. It's very difficult. But with God, you can do all things. All things. I know we went through a very difficult time when the church grew autonomy. Very, very, extremely difficult time. But I never gave up. I never gave up on God. We lost everything that was material. House, car, we only didn't have a heart for the church, it's gone. Everything we lost. But I never gave up. I never gave up. It's not easy to sit and watch a truck taking your stuff away to put in storage. It's not easy to watch all this. And my husband wasn't working. I'm going to talk about my two children. They were in university, Lee University. I put them into a Christian university. And my husband wasn't working. My salary at QC. This just was impossible. And I remember them going back one Saturday. They had their American passport, so that's no problem there, and no money to go back. They probably had about $100. And my husband went to the bank, and the bank said, take them home. And I said, no, you're not coming home in the name of Jesus. And They went back, and Erica called me the next day, said, "Mommy, my fees are paid." I didn't ask how. And she said, "I have some left over." And I said, "Run and take it to the register and pay it on Elsa's fee." And I mean, guys, people, don't give up. Don't give up. We have a true God, a living God, and a testimony of that. And all this hardship, you know, I didn't tell you, my brothers and sisters, they're all important people as far as that's concerned, because they all went to top universities all over the world. And so, but because, for example, my brother went, I had two brothers who went to the University of London, one did economics, and the other did engineering. Mr. Moss, Michael Moss knows him very well. Another brother, well, the one who did economics, he became professor in Canada. My brother, the guy called it, he went to the University of New York. And the older ones were married and gone. I have one who was in the government, he was the MP. But I lived in Mandeville with a brother and his wife, and they were glad to have me because they had two girls, one is a lawyer, one is a doctor, and they were married and gone. So I was so good, it was so good for them to have me in their lives. But what I'm saying is, don't give up on Jesus. Don't give up on the Lord. He can do anything and everything. It doesn't matter what it is, God can do it. He is a great God. He's a good God. He's the Almighty. We have nobody, when you are down and out, we have nobody else but God Almighty. Nobody else. They can solve your problems. They might say, "I'll help you," you said, but God is the ultimate answer to our problems. I prove it day and night. QC was good to me, but not very good at the end. Dr. Sula, no pension. I'm not talking because I don't have it. I have all my brothers and sisters God has given me. I'm down and out. If I say today, I need so and so, it will be here by next week. And that's the way we were brought up. You have to love one another, love your family, love your sisters, your brothers, love the people. You know, and it humbles me because I have a neighbor who is, you know, she's not a poor religion, but it doesn't matter. God said, love your neighbors. And they had a son that died recently, and he had an operation, and so it was difficult for them, very, very, very difficult, but she's not well herself, you know, and I would go over there. His garbage day, and I take the garbage and I put it onto the gate. And the garbage truck goes and put it back on their porch. And this is how I want to live. I want to live a life that is fulfilling in God's sight. I want when God comes and He says, "Are you ready?" I will be able to say, "Yes, I am." So I am just encouraging you today. I'm encouraging you. We have problems. There are problems. But there is room that is too difficult for God to fix. So just be in God's plans. He will fix it. If you come here with a problem today, God can fix it. So I thank you for listening, and I hope you do the best, and I hope you get something from what I say. Hold on to your children. Hold on to your children. Teach them. Show them. And if God can do it for my family, I know He can do it for your family. Thank you.
announcement, and offertory prayer will be done by Sister Miller Winters.
I am no longer a slave to fear. Why? Because I've got Christ. I'm a child of God, and I know each and every one of you here this morning. This morning, because we didn't have to be here this morning. Well, you have us here. I mean, good spirits, all dressed up beautifully with our lovely colors, especially the women with our lovely colors, looking so beautiful on Mother's Day. And the men, of course, look at our pastor. He's three piece this morning. He has all the babies. Watch him go. Brother Bert is beautiful and light and coming high. Now, Brother Dean right there, his head come down. Let me see you, Brother Dean. And all the fine gentlemen here this morning, but okay, get my name mixed up here a little bit. All the fine young men and handsome brothers we have in this church here this morning, we welcome you so much and so happy that you've come to be with your respective loved ones, mother, sister, aunt, or whatever that you have here with you this morning. Thank God for everything that's happened to us. And Sister Erica, as usual. Where did she go? Yeah, there you go. Of course, you sang so beautifully. And I just love how you did a special relationship interaction with your mom. It was so nice. Yeah, you know what? You have your mother here with you this morning. Thank God. For all of us who don't have our mothers here with us this morning, we thank him anyway more so. We thank you for his great love and mercies. Now, our notices. I have this name, Stubbs. The young man, he's a young man from Fort Lauderdale, Trevor. I think his name is Trevor. And I have relatives of Sister Davis here this morning. I Tia, Rhonda Davis, and you're welcome here. Mother and sister of your Stacy, Stacy's family. Stacy, I hear you down in the back there. I can't see you so well. Yeah. And her family members. Oh, she's on this side. Yeah, there you go. There you go. Right. So nice to have you all this morning. Thank you so much for being with us this morning. And to the other visitors whom perhaps we don't have their names, of course, the same extension, same love extended to you all here this morning. And thank you so much for coming to St. Paul's and worshiping with us. I notice this in our... Anyone give me any other notice? No. I got them all, I think. Sister Peggy, I got them all here. But our notices and announcements, I'm going to just give you one or two of them that we have here that you need to know. Just one, the new one is myself and Sister Diane. Sister Diane, you here with us this morning? And I didn't see Midland. Sister Sheila's here, that's her problem. So we have someone to just go in the back. Yeah. Okay, the Festival of Ascension at St. The Festival of Ascension will be this Thursday, May 18th at 6 o'clock. May 18th at 6 here at St. Paul's Church. It's a circuit service, and all members are encouraged to attend as we celebrate the ascension of our Lord and Savior. Our birthday anniversary goes out this week to Raven Grant, Sage Smith, and Orlando Knowles. And on the 16th is Tracy Walkings. That's our birthdays. I think Raven is the 15th. Raven and Sage and Orlando are on the 15th, and 16th is Tracy. So we wish those young people a very, very happy and loving birthday, and we pray that they get a lovely cake from their parents and all the lovely things you get them on your birthdays and gifts. Confirmation classes begins on the 6th, right here at the church, 3 p.m., 12 years old and older. And of those who wants to renew their, know more about confirmations or about, can also attend and reverence and welcome them as well. Aldersgate Sunday is May 21st, and we'll have a service here at 5, and the members, the congregation, are asked to practice a Wesley hymn that they can forward and will be selected as the hymn. And there will be a procession of witness from St. Paul's Church starting at 4 p.m. promptly. And the elders' gate will start at 5, so please be on time. The procession starts at 4, right around the church here. The Circuit Women's Fellowship Monday meeting, Monday, May 22nd, and we are asking each and everyone to come up because I think it's going to be our last meeting for the year. And the youth in St. Quentro 2024, that's where the youth go away, and it's next year. So we are also asking, it's not here in the bulletin, but we are asking for donations to assist the youth. I think it's about 6 of them, hopefully will be going. And so we're looking for donations to assist the youth in their trip and their youth in Central, where they'll learn and how to practice it. Maybe in another 10 years, they'll be here at the podium and doing the things that we are doing here today. It's like registration for it is like $1,150. So they will need some help. So let us help them out there the best we can. Excuse me. Now, St. Andrew's Methodist Church. They are having their 56th anniversary, and God is changing how I think is their theme. And so they're asking, they're having two nights of revival on the 24th and 25th, which is Wednesday and Thursday. And there's going to be a service on the 28th, which is Sunday. And their guest speaker will be a pastor, Richard Notice. I hope I pronounced the last name. It's written as Notice, but you know, Notice. Mm-hmm. From Sanctuary Church of God in Orlando, Florida. He'll be our guest preacher. So we ask you all to come out to the 10th St. Andrews now. Come, be down there now, the 10th St. Andrews, and support, give them some support. Now, let the pastors sing. You know, we have a singing pastor, right? So the concert I mentioned, May 21st, at Calvary, is going to be at Calvary, 7 o'clock. So from here, we go straight to Calvary. Now, I don't know which Calvary you're thinking about, but I'm thinking of the Calvary Church, well, the church here, or the town here. Because I know people are thinking, unless I'm thinking, Calvary, yeah, no, not that Calvary here. Like that. You don't get in like that easy. And of course, we have our sip and our shut-in, and we're asking for prayers for them. Asking for prayers for our sip and shut-in from the various Methodist churches. So all those that you know, please, you know, say a prayer and go and visit them. Now, that's what else I have here. There should be the Golden Jubilee Grand Parade. That's Wednesday, 24th, and it's going to be at the Harold D. Gregory Complex, right, and Pizza Hut. That's what they have here in the letter, 9:30 on Wednesday, 24th. And guess who's going to be there? The marching bands and our own legend, along with the Royal Bahamas Defense and the Royal Bahamas Police. Now, you know how we like music, and we like to be part of the band. So they're going to be out there. Also, our Bahama Brass Band. Now, that's going to be on the 24th, which is Wednesday, and that will be out by the Harold and Gray Complex and the Pizza Hut in that area. So if you want to go and see and watch them, you can go at that time. Okay. Now, it should be further noted, okay. Now, performance on our 50th anniversary, right, is going to be by these following individuals whom you probably know and would want to follow. Ms. Terry Johnson, Mr. Sheree Taylor, Pastor Simeon Owen, Royal Bahamas Police Band, and the Grand Bahama Police Band, Pop Band. Okay, that's for the Golden Jubilee Grand Parade and Rally. And it's in honor of our 50th anniversary of independence. Okay, so all those who, like I said, who love bands and stuff like that, go on out there and enjoy yourself and just have a nice time. Okay, are there any other notices? I think I called on where you stay with your family and everyone. Okay, thank you so much for that. We'll now ask you to please stand for the offertory prayer. Thank you.
Father, this morning we come before you, asking you as always, always asking you, Father, isn't that something? Always asking you for something. But you know our hearts. You know our hearts are good. You know that we love you. We care for you. We just know that you love us, that you also care for us. So just thank you for giving us this opportunity again this morning to come here and worship with you. Be able to stand upright and speak and talk and sing and do everything. Because you gave us this strength. Without you, we couldn't be here this morning. So we just want to give you thanks and praise, God, because we love you and we just thank you. And we're going to give you those thanks and praise in the form of offerings, because we know it's offerings that takes care of the church, takes care of the sick, takes care of the poor, and helps us to be good servants of God. So we ask you to make generous donations this morning to the church so that the church can continue its work in serving and helping the poor and the needy. Your precious name, we ask all of this. In the lovely name of your Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. We thank you. Amen. So come on up and drop your monies.
Your big checks. I was a big check this morning now. Big.
Not the check side. I'm talking about the money in the check. Money in the hand. It's a big money.
The light.
Should I be open till 3 in the morning?
No. This can't happen. This cannot happen. If you can't abide by my rules, you need to go. Go. Go.
Where are you going? Being a mom, okay? Let me pray for you. Heavenly Father, we ask that you show compassion over her and her household. We pray, oh God, that they will have understanding and love. We ask you, God, to take away the animosity and replace it with your everlasting love. Amen.
Amen.
More.
With all our hearts and mind, let us pray to the Lord, saying, Lord, in your mercy, for the peace and welfare of the world, for the witness and work of the church, and for the unity of all people, but especially here in the Bahamas, Lord, in your mercy, for our connectional and conference presidents and ministers of God's work, and sacrament here in Grand Bahama City, that they may be filled with truth. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For the sick, the suffering, the sorrowful, and the dying, and for all those who have lost loved ones, that they may find comfort in your Holy Spirit. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for mothers who have lost children and those who are grieving the loss of their mother. Grant them peace and comfort. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
God of generations, thank you for the gift of faith kindled and rekindled in us through this year. And thank you for those who have taught us the faith in sincerity and love. Today we give special thanks and praise for our church mothers, the mothers who, like Timothy's mother and grandmother, steadily and without much recognition, continue to teach a new generation of children about the love of Jesus. May God bless all women on this special day. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
All together.
O Lord our God, accept the fervent prayers of your people here at St. Paul's and this church. Look with compassion on us and all of us who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O Lord of love, and we live in your glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
Now we will get a special treat as I call our superintendent minister, Reverend Elkanah Seymour, to come forward.
Thank you very much, Sister Gloria, Mama Gloria. Happy Mother's Day to all the mothers. And I remember one of my colleagues was here in the Bahamas, and it is something when you say different things in different cultures. And he said, it is Mother's Day. I want us to big up all the mothers today. And just like how you're laughing, he said, but what happened, what happened, what happened? You see, in the Leeward Islands, if you say big up the mothers, it means give them a lot of praise. But if you say big them up here in the Bahamas, it means get them pregnant. I must say a word on my mother. I'm in church because of her. She had 10 of us. 9 boys and 1 girl. I'm the last of the my sister was the second child, and it wasn't easy for her. She was a church woman. Dad was a church man too. He used to play the big tuba, big horn, and conduct choirs and all the rest of it. But when she wanted to go to church in the evenings, he always would say to her, "Let us stay home." She said, "No, I need to go, praise my Lord." And he would say to her, "If anything happens to you out there, walk past the house." And so sometimes I had to walk her to church. And walking her to church, I got to like church. And also, you know, get closer to her. And so when I went off to Jamaica to study, and even when I went off to the Leeward Islands to live, every time I came home, I would always get a tub of warm water and soak her feet in it and massage her legs and cut her toenails. She's the only one, I'm the only one who she would allow to cut her nails. And so one time I came home and I didn't do it. She said, "Hey, what happened, man? You forgot your job?" I said, "No, Mom, I'm coming right now," and I would do whatever. But she taught me so many things. And I'm so grateful to her for teaching me those things. And even I can do some of the things that she taught me better than she. Yes, I can. But God has blessed me with her. And she has passed in 2013. Four of us are left, but we give God thanks for her. I was asked here to come here and give a special selection, and that selection I want to do comes from Lenny Williams. In 1979, he sang a song that I love, and I think it's very fitting for the mothers this morning. And so it goes something like this. She was the fourth generation of kindness and patience. The knack for love flowed strong in her blood. So she thought it not strange, bearing my pain and believing me each step of the way. Oh, here's to the lady
We have come to the end of a very special service. And I pray that you have been truly blessed as we close with the hymn, Hark My Soul, It Is the Lord. Please stand.
We apologize. Please be seated.
Okay. Special presentations by the Women's Fellowship.
To the front, to the back, side, and today we feel that it is a wonderful opportunity to do so. So first, starting with our guest speaker, a lady that is so full, a lady that is so worthy of grace, a lady that is so faithful. We're honored to have Mrs. Ena Weir as our speaker. The lesson she brought to us, all the reminders of how we are to display and live motherhood. Thank you so very much, Sister Weir.
My sister here.
Yes, she is. And something else for you. We so appreciate everything you have done and we ask our complete blessings.
Thank you so much.
And there are a few other ladies in the congregation. Sister Judy, Judy Fritz. I don't know if Judy is here today. I don't remember seeing her. But this lady is Judy. Judy takes care of us in ways that you would not imagine. When we come into the sanctuary and when we just use and abuse and misuse, Judy is there to clean up after us, to tidy us, and to remind us that she loves us in spite of. Judy, thank you so very much. Sister Deborah, please come. This lady has a heart of gold. Anything this church is having, without even asking, she said, what is it that you're doing again? And she's right there with her hands wide open and giving and taking. Probably saw her at the door, and she left there and went in the kitchen. Special, but this lady has become a special. special sister in Christ. We spend mornings together, 5 a.m. every morning except Saturday, then we're at 7. I'm going to call my sister Patricia Dickinson. Another person that gives so much, local preacher, she goes from St. Paul's to St. Andrews to St. David's. She goes all around. She reaches out in so, so many ways. We don't even know. We don't know. She's that quiet giver, that quiet, loving heart. And let me tell you, a woman that can pray, oh my, a woman that can pray. Faithful, faithful servant of God. I wish you the very best. The very best. Bible camp up here. Again, very, very kind lady. very giving, quietly. She gives more than finances. She gives words of wisdom. She is one that Sister Faye can always trust because of her faithfulness and dedication to the young people in our church. And we love you, Sharon, and we thank you very, very much. And it's so good to have you back. And I believe that ends all of our presentations. Again, we thank you, and to the mothers, we wish you a joyous and just wonderful, wonderful Mother's Day. Be happy, be glad, be grateful. Okay? Thank you so much. God bless each and every one.
Right, as I said earlier, we have come.
Yes.
To the end of a very special service. And I pray that as we have been truly blessed, as we close with the name, heart, my soul, it is the Lord.
Thank you.
now of the benediction, my brother Bert Nyburn. And at the end, please don't run off. We have a treat for each person. Please get something on your way out. Thank you.
The hand that rocks the cradle rules the world. Every king who ever sat on the throne, every prime minister, every captain that sailed the high seas, every carpenter, every mason, they all have a mother. It begins with a mother. Sitting there this morning, I reminisce about my dear mother. You know, we all had that mother's love. And those who didn't, they miss a very special thing. I grew up in a house with four boys, and my father was always out sailing on the seas, and she had to deal with four boys. I was the worst one. But I think of her praying, and she never really got upset. She was such a gracious Christian lady. I got tired of going to Sunday school and church during the day and the evening, but I thank God for that upbringing. And to all of the mothers, you have an awesome responsibility because you control what happens in this world. So mothers, please pay attention to those children. The Bible says to train up the child in the way he should go. And when he is old, it will not depart from him. So let us be mindful of this great responsibility. On that, I wish all the mothers a very special Mother's Day. God bless you. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we give you a special thanks today, special thanks for mothers. For without mothers, where would we be? Dear Lord, we just ask you to bless the young mothers, bless the elder mothers, wherever they go, wherever they are, be with them, O God, and give them your special guidance and your special protection. Those who are ill, we just ask you, O God, to heal and deliver them, for you have the balm that can heal any sensitive soul. We ask your blessing on all of the offspring. We ask your blessings on the church and all who are listening in through special media. We just ask you to give them your special blessing today on this Mother's Day. Now let us be dismissed. The grace, the saving grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us all now and forevermore. And the people of God say, Amen. Amen.
How are you today?